Hey, this is an intake camshaft from a 1zz-fe Toyota engine. That's a 1.8-liter engine from the Corolla, Matrix, Celica, Pontiac Vibe, and maybe some other models too that I don't know about. We did a previous video about locking and unlocking this VVT-i gear. In this video, we're going to open up the gear and look inside, so that everyone can understand better how this gear works and what it does. Up close you see that these bolts that hold the cover on the VVT-i gear are five-sided bolts, and you can buy a penta nut or whatever set of sockets, penta sockets. I think this is a 11 millimeter because I have a 10 millimeter penta socket and a 12 millimeter penta socket. The 10 is too small, the 12 is too big. So this must be an 11, which is a really unusual size. But anyway, we don't really need that because these are just small bolts, and you can put a vice grip on the head of the bolt and break it loose, and once you do that you can turn the bolt by hand the rest of the way and it comes right out. And we can do that with all four bolts and get them off. So this is the spring that I was talking about, and you can just pull it right out and set it aside. So with this spring out of the pin, we can rotate this freely back and forth. We can take a look at what it does. This is the neutral position where the pin engages into the little locking cavity underneath the pin. And this is the position that this gear returns to every time you stop the car. So when you start the car, it builds up oil pressure and it pushes this pin back out, and then this can rotate. Okay, and it goes from its neutral position to its position of maximum advance. And the thing that keeps it from going past this position right here is a little pin that you can see right there in the bottom. So this pin, once it hits this flange right here, it stops the rotation. You can see the pin down in there. Okay, back and forth. So the way this moves back and forth is that the oil control valve controls the oil pressure on both sides. So if you have more pressure on this side, this moves this way. If you have more pressure on this side, it moves back this way. And the same with the other four cavities. So now that we've looked at the operation of this gear, let's look at the assembly. This bolt holds the entire gear down to the camshaft, so we can break it loose and remove it. And then once we do that, we can remove the top part of the assembly. Okay, and this is the part that has the two components that rotate relative to each other, and this leaves the back plate right here. And at this point I can just push this pin all the way out, and you can see that this pin can engage right into this hole right here, and this is what locks the gear in place. Now when I look at the back side of this gear, you'll see that it has three slots and one slot is rounded. This slot right here is the one that the rounded slot is the one that must be matched up with the pin on this back plate, this smaller pin. And this bigger pin is the limiting pin that controls the over rotation of the VVT gear. So in putting this back together, we take note of this slot on the outside of this gear, and it must match with another slot that is on the back plate. I don't know if you can see it clearly, but this slot is right here. Let me move the camera so you can see it better. So right there is the slot on the back plate that must match up with this slot on the top plate. So let's reassemble this gear. So there, it all fell right into place, and these two slots are lined up, and we just make sure that the gear is seated. And there we have it. It's just back to its original position. The pin is still unlocked, so we can turn it back and forth. And now to seal it back up, we put the spring in. We put this cover on, and on the cover, we can see the location of the spring. It has some wear on it that you can feel right here. So we just line that back up, line up all the holes, and we can get these bolts started. And actually, it would be a good idea to replace these M6 bolts with hex bolts so we can torque them back down properly to a known torque. Okay, so that was our look inside the VVT gear. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.